Yesterday, I turned this 3D printed prototype of the height independent marble divider into a full scale plywood version. The whole purpose with this design is that this marble divider doesn't care about the height of the top marble, which makes it possible for me to get rid of all these parts and not only solve the problem of the marble height, it totally ignores it. There's no place to attach screws in the middle of these parts, so I need to glue them together. While the glue is drying, I'm going to machine 38 of these cats.
Meow.
I start with two drilling operations. First, the small through holes that go straight through the whole part. And then secondly, I do the countersinks here. That's the larger holes where the head of the screw can sink into. After that, I start to machine the contour. And since I'm making so many of the same parts, I didn't want to have a lot of post-processing or sanding of each and every 38 parts. I spent quite a lot of time programming the toolpaths and choosing the right cutters to make the parts come off almost completely finished directly from the CNC table. I'm leaving one tab, and here I'm holding down each piece while I'm using a 2mm cutter to cut them loose. The gluing looks perfect, and now we have our cats to put on here. The cats are nearly perfect off the CNC machine. Now I need to pilot drill these holes for the cat's eyes. I'm using two acrylic pipes to position the cat to pilot drill, and I'm using a little stop block on the drill so I can always drill to exactly the same depth. Then I can attach all the 38 cats to the assembly, and then things are starting to look finished. When I was done putting all the cats on, I was like, I have a group of 19 stray cats here. There's 38 channels on the Marble Machine X. I forgot that each cat handles two channels, so I made twice the amount I needed. Guys, you have to go into the World Tour drawer. I'm doing some extra roll test looking at this angle, because if I can use the old fittings on top of the machine, which has 5-degree angle on this axis, things would get much easier for me, but it rolls pretty slow. Nah. It's on the limit. As you can see, it rolls very slow, but I'm going to try to angle it even more like this. 13. I'm a little bit disappointed that the window I have to tweak this to is kind of small, too slow and the marble stick, too fast and the marble skip the holes. And I was hoping for a larger window, easier to tweak. Let's try this one, 13 degrees. Oh, you know what? This feels very good. This is a stubborn hole here. I rounded over this sharp edge. On Rosero's prototype, that edge is knife sharp. The round over I added creates just a tiny little extra place for the marble to get stuck. They're almost running too fast now, so let's tilt it down a little bit again. Still a little slow. Ooh, 12. Let's just try it. Okay, 11. Too slow. So this angle is just under 5 degrees, which is what we have on the machine. Okay, this looks very nice. Some holes get skipped, that's not a big issue actually. I ended up experimenting a lot with the different angles, this way and this way. And as I said, I'm a little bit disappointed that the tweaking window is quite small. I would have liked it to be larger. So the question isn't if I can make it work. I can make it work, but the question is if I can make it work with the original angle. Yesterday I was tweaking around the settings and this works, but the window where it works is worryingly small. And I started work with to put it on the machine. I was like, no, it doesn't feel right. I'm going to make a bold claim here. Different materials have different properties. I know you don't believe me. I think the problems I'm having with the plywood version is due to the fact that I couldn't exactly copy this prototype. Let me show you. In the 3D printed prototype, there's a razor sharp edge here, which allows the surrounding plastic to be very tight to this marble right here. On the plywood version, I rounded over that edge with the Dremel. And look at all this space here. I can put a screwdriver in between the wood and the marble here, but I can't do that here. I've created a little pocket here for the marble to rest in like that. On this prototype, that pocket exists, but it's much, much smaller. I couldn't leave a razor thin edge of thin plywood that would just break, but I didn't foresee that it would cause so much issues. That was my first mistake. For my second mistake, we have to look at it from the other direction. My second mistake is that I rounded over these walls. I fretted about the fact that the marbles could chew up the plywood, so I made a fillet around this edge. And on the 3D print, that's a sharp, flat edge. So here the marbles can pass pretty easily, and the little divot between the marble and the wall is pretty small. But if we go over to the plywood version, this divot here is much larger. You could look at designing in different dimensions, and shapes is one dimension, and material is a completely other dimension. And plywood has its limitations, although I hate to admit it. And in this case, it's just not possible to make these sharp structures from the plywood material. Then I was thinking, maybe I could machine this from another direction. I made a CAD design of a top sleeve. So I'm taking all the old parts and I'm cutting off the top, and then I'm adding this, the top sleeve. And here's the CAD for a machining test part in POM. Immediately when I started the CNCing, I felt, oh, this is so much nicer. It doesn't smell and it machines nicely and it starts to shine after some time. So I got super excited and this is the final result. It's so cool. So the latest generation, the POM version. Let's try all three and see which one performs best. Ultimate Material Showdown, it's the ultimate material now. Who will win Ultimate Material Showdown? I vote for plywood. Three contenders, only one can win Ultimate Material Showdown. I have my energy back because of the POM. I'm gonna tell you this angle. It's 8. That's too much. Calm down. don't fall. Ultimate Material 25. That's what Rosero prototyped in the beginning. They got stuck. We have our first casualty. Let's try POM. Ooh, smooth. Let's try Rosero. Test one. One got stuck on the plywood. Nothing on the PM, nothing on the prototype. Let's try another angle. 520. I'm gonna put two parts of plywood under here. So I'm gonna make the angle more and more difficult and see which part fails first. X axis is 420 and Y axis is 25. Oh. This one got stuck there. POM with the same exact angles. Flawless. Rosero, same angles. Also flawless. So again, I'm going to put a plywood piece under here, make it more difficult. 3 degrees. one marble stack, three marble stack. Plywood is clogged. Butter smooth even though I released that marble super slow. And Rosera. Smooth. I'm gonna try another height on the POM because, as you know, the point of this is that the marbles can be on different heights. I'm just adding some cardboard here. That works. Good. Adding another piece here. 2 degrees. Only reason to roll the plywood is to show you how fast it fails. Fail. Fail. This doesn't roll. POM. Oh, that one got stuck. Yeah, it's not entirely fair because the marbles are not at the same height in the 3D print and the POM. Let's shift the marble height of the POM to something else. Okay, so POM is also struggling with this non-existing slope, so we're all good. Great result. The POM version and the 3D printed prototype is very similar and way better than the plywood. And now I want to change this direction. On the machine, we can tilt it in this direction along the axis, which is an option I have left for later. So for the ultimate last test, I'm going to put this POM part on the real marble divider on top of the Marble Machine X. That way we know if the POM would actually work in the exact same original angle, which would save me so much work from rebuilding much more than what I want to. So here's the piece of POM, the same angle as the marble divider. No problems. Okay, so let's try now to angle it like this, because that's the setting adjustment we have at our disposal. I'm tilting it forwards like this. That feels very good. Let's try to get this to stick. Oh, it's easier now. That's an amazing setting. I'm 100% confident that this will work on this slope and just find the correct tilt. Very happy about this. I'm confident we're going in the right direction. I'm really happy that I didn't accept that it kind of works pretty well state of this that I found yesterday. It's also my analogy, if you remember, of an unstable system. So for example, if I wanted to, I can balance these two wood blocks on the table. I could say, look at that, we have a functioning system for now in the best case. All of a sudden, someone bumps the table and things falling. And this is what I've learned from experience throughout this whole project. When things works in a small tweaking window, don't trust it. Things has to work also in the edge cases. That is a good design. The mechanical behind this design from the Discord community is the fact that the material has to be tight around the marble. You don't want like a large ditch around the marble, a treacherous river in which the other marbles can get stuck and drown. I think even though things look messy now, I'm so much more critical nowadays and I don't buy 99.99% solutions. I want the march of nines to be longer than that. Next steps for me is to design and machine the full length PM version and attach it to the top of the plywood version. I can still save the work we did on the plywood and I can merge these two into hopefully a functional thing. That will be in the next video. Thank you so much for watching and following the crazy project that is the Marble Machine X. Special thanks to all the patrons and all the YouTube members. Thanks to your support, I can finish this project. I'm confident I will make the Marble Machine work. I will not give up until the Marble Machine X is working. I'm having so much fun with this right now. So thanks everyone for following and have a wonderful weekend. I will see you next week.